This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. From Bangor, Pennsylvania to Bangor, Wales, Nicole Brewer spent the day with the Bangor High School band to see why they traveled thousands of miles away to connect and pay tribute to their Welsh heritage.
Tradition, pride, and excellence. Three words that describe the beating heart of the Bangor High School band. Made up of 150 students, the band is the most visual manifestation of the town's Welsh heritage.
With people moving in, moving out, all that type of stuff, there was still something that they would say, this is a Bangor student, you know, and there's that sense of pride in that community.
A community built on the traditions of those that came before them.
Who we are today and what we've become today is in part because of the culture that grew up around the slate industries.
Founded in 1875, the town of Bangor was the center of a slate mining industry and became home to many Welsh immigrants who were slaters by trade. Now considered a dying art form, this town's slate roots are being kept alive through the mark of the slater spirit and the sound of its band.
The music, the style, everything that we do certainly has the Welsh roots embedded in it.
And just 2 months ago, these students got the rare opportunity to take their Welsh pride one step further by taking a trip from Bangor, Pennsylvania to Bangor, Wales.
Well, I wasn't sure whether I was going to get 5, 10, 50, you know, I was hoping just to get a band.
And how many did you get?
Well, we ended up having 150, which was quite overwhelming.
The group's overseas trip included a highly publicized and jam-packed performance schedule that took them from the Royal Air Force Base in Anglesey to the Welsh Slate Museum in Llanberis. It also included a parade appearance down High Street in Bangor.
There were people on either side. People came out of their stores. You know, they stopped business to see what was going on and to, you know, just witness the event.
We were really proud to be there and proud to have made the connection from our Bangor to their Bangor.
But day two wasn't over. Later that night, they played at the Bangor Cathedral.
Welsh people packed the place, sit-down concert, member of parliament, a queen's representative.
All there to see an American band pay tribute to its Welsh roots. But it was senior drum major Anna Gothard that really brought down the house with her rendition of the Welsh national anthem.
Once she started singing, the whole cathedral just erupted in song. You couldn't even hear the band, you know. I mean, they were just singing that loud.
And I was listening to them, and I was listening so much pride for their country.
Pride that led these students to appreciate the meaning behind the songs they've played so often, but have never fully understood. For junior band member Adam Odenwelder, the song Men in Harlech came to life during a trip to Harlech Castle.
You play it for 3-4 years, and it's kind of just there, but then you go play in the castle, and these people over there in Wales who've grown up there their entire lives are crying, and it, you know, it brings so much joy to their hearts.
And as one student discovered the meaning behind the music, another student came face to face with her Welsh roots.
Well, I visited Jerusalem Chapel in Bethesda, Wales, and that is where my great-great-great-great, all the way back, uncle, Reverend Morris Jones, first preached.
Era Lee also had the opportunity to meet one of her distant cousins, Laura Hughes, a native of Wales.
I'm glad to have seen her and to have met her, and it was nice to say, oh, this is my family.
The group's final performance was held at Carnarvon Castle, where the students were granted another rare opportunity.
We performed right in front of a circular, huge circular slate, a slate where only the Queen is allowed to stand on to appoint the Prince of Wales.
And according to band director Craig Payne, it was the perfect way to end a successful trip.
That was one of the things that people wanted us to do 20 years ago, and there we are doing that. Powerful.
Someone once said that the greatest legacy we can leave our children is the gift of roots and the gift of wings. And here in Bangor, it's clear these kids have received both. For Tempo, I'm Nicole Brewer reporting.